Hi, this is Mark, and this is the HEPA Air Purifier Guide brought to you by AliveAirPurifier.com. HEPA stands for High Efficiency Particulate Air, and this was developed in the 1940s to filter out radiation dust. Even though it's only one of the top 10 air purifiers or types of air purifiers, it's really considered the best. And as you can see, the filters come in both round form and also square form. Here's a before and after picture of a small HEPA filter that came out of a small purifier I had in my bedroom for about a year. The new filter is the one on the left. As you can see, the HEPA is a cloth filter. It kind of accordions in and out, and it gathers and holds pollen, dust, and dirt. There are thousands of HEPA air purifiers on the market. Three of the top units and units I like being the IQ Air, the Austin Air, and the Alive Air machine. Then you also have your Hunter, Honeywell, Holmes, and some of the less expensive ones, but I don't recommend them. They tend to be loud, and I just don't find they work as well. And then, so you know, the Oric, some of the Ionic models, and a lot of the other popular brands do not include HEPA. So they're not really as effective for dust or pollen. HEPA is really the first thing you want to choose. So what are some of the pros of HEPA? Well, first of all, it captures hair, pollen, and dust, and that's why it's considered best for allergies, even by doctors. And then it's up to 99.97% effective at removing particles down to 0.03 microns. And to give an idea, I think a human hair is about 50 microns. So it's very small particles it'll pick up. The thing to really be aware of when buying a HEPA purifier is the replacement filters. And it's a lot like when you buy an inkjet printer, and then maybe you spend $100 on that, and then you go to replace the little inkjet cartridge, the little thing of ink, you know, 3 or 4 months down the road, and they're going to charge you $45 for this little tiny thing of ink. Well, the HEPA air purifiers are a lot like that, that you buy the machine and then you go to buy the replacement HEPA filter, and I've seen ones that run like a couple $100. So you just want to be aware of that. So besides the replacement filter costs, and by the way, you usually change those filters about every 9 to 12 months. You just check them periodically. Once they start to get brown or black, it's time to replace them. The other con of HEPA is that it doesn't really help with odors, gases, viruses, germs, bacteria, etc. It'll help a little bit with mold spores, but won't really get rid of the mold. So that's kind of the downside of it. So my suggestions are, number one, shop for an affordable replacement filter before you buy the air purifier. And affordable will be $30 is good, $140 at the most, and that would be for a really high-end air purifier. And then the second thing, besides HEPA, I'd look for a machine that also includes UV, and that way it's going to kill viruses, germs, mold, bacteria, etc. There's some other technologies I like as well, and some of those you can find on some of my other HEPA video reviews, where I'll review these HEPA air purifiers. And this, you'll find all these videos at AliveAirPurifier.com. You're also going to find my review of some of the top 10 air purifiers. We'll get some of your questions answered, video reviews. There's a consumer feedback blog. You'll also find coupons and savings as well. And so that's a little bit about AliveAirPurifier.com. Now, if you got some help from this video, if you would leave a rating, embed the video, leave a comment, or ask me any question you'd like in the comment section. I'll try to respond as quickly as I can. Thanks for watching the HEPA Air Purifier Guide.